Hola, soy Emerson Sosa, and now we're going to talk about stretch clusters. And it turns out this is one of the reasons, besides SPVM, that I really got interested in vSAN. And I'll explain why in a minute. But first, let's describe what a stretch cluster is. Well, actually, just remind you, because we've been using stretch clusters since the beginning of time. A stretch cluster is you have two locations, and you have a number of hosts in location one, a number of hosts in location two, and you connect the two to be part of the same vSphere cluster. Hence stretch, right? Different locations. When it comes to vSAN, however, there are some conditions that we must meet. One of them is that in each data center, you can have up to 15 ESXi hosts for a total of 30. And then because you have two locations, you need a third location to be the witness. So we're going to have location number three, which is going to hold an ESXi host in a virtual appliance that is going to be the witness. Another condition, is that the distance between these two guys, the round trip delay, RTT, it should not be more than 200 milliseconds. Of course, you want it closer to that for better performance because the witness is going to be constantly be updated with information. So that said, another condition is that between the two data centers, you have to have no more than 5 millisecond round trip delay either. So the two data centers have to be close in proximity to each other, more like a metro cluster, if you wish. Now, how do you configure this, right? You have 15 hosts. How does vSAN do it? And it turns out it's rather simple. What vSAN does is that when you configure vSAN, vSAN groups all these 15 hosts in something called a fault domain. A fault domain is a collection of ESXi hosts for vSAN purposes, where vSAN, instead of thinking at the host as the failure construct, is going to think as all the hosts in that failure domain as the failure construct, and you will make decision based on that. So you will have fault domain number one, fault domain number two, and you will have fault domain number three, which is the witness. So we have our stretch cluster configured. So what's next? We need to have a VM. And the VM, here it is, is going to have an FDT policy of failures to tolerate of one, with a rate of one, which means one copy of the objects for the VM will be copied locally. The other copy will be across the data center interconnect to the other location. So that's an FDT of one with a rate, a method of one. That's what we have. However, there is an additional FTT that you can leverage here. You see, this VM's object in here is in one host as it stands right now. If that host dies, that means that the recovery has to come from, the replication has to come from the other data center, the other failure domain. And that means that it's going to cross across the DCI. And if you talk to any network engineer that is working on data center, this connection is sacred. It's really, really important. Therefore, you try to minimize the traffic that goes across it so that you don't have impact production. Therefore, you can have a second failure to tolerate of one or two with a method of rate one or erasure coding of rate five or six. And that's local, so both locations will have that. Now, we have two failures to tolerate, and that's kind of confusing, right? Using the same term for the same thing. Therefore, this failure to tolerate that's between data centers, we're going to call it primary failure to tolerate. And the other failure to tolerate, which is local to the data center, is going to be called the secondary failure to tolerate. So you have those options for the SPVM for each VM as you deploy them in this data center. Now, the one thing that I really like about this, which I mentioned at the beginning of the video, is that, you see, when this VM does a write locally, when vSAN does the write locally, the write also has to go across and be written here. And until the other data center replies and acknowledges the write, until that happens, that VM doesn't get the write acknowledgement. That means that because you have the writes being acknowledged on both sides, they protect it, you have an RPO of zero, which means you finally have a storage solution that natively allows you to be able to have your data replicated across two different locations without having to spend lots of money to have metro cluster storage. That's what I really like about this. And now that we have an RPO zero, and one thing I should mention, kind of digressing a bit, that all of this is under the same vCenter. So finally now, when what you have is that if something happens to that VM or this data center, you can enable vSphere HA to restore that VM over here. Because you had RPO of zero, there's no data loss. And because you're recovering your VM exactly as it was before, you don't need other replication technologies or recovery technology automation like SRM, for example. Native to vSphere, you can have complete protection and recoverability of minutes, automated without any human intervention. And that's a stretch cluster. I am your vSAN Sosa. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.